Hello students, hope you are fine. Let's continue our class. We were learning chapter 3 of civics, the government. In this chapter, some of you are asking me that I have not taught chapter 2. We have done civics chapter 1 and we are doing 3 and 4 as 3 and 4 is going to come in your half yearly exam. And one more thing to remember, whatever I teach you, whatever I explain you, only those chapters will come. Okay, so we will be doing chapter 3, continuing this chapter. We have learnt already why we need government, what is government, what are the works of government. We learnt yesterday making rules, hana, all that, and making people to follow those rules. Today we have to see levels of government. Levels of government, local, state and national. Now, levels of government on page 213. You saw the government has many functions to perform. We know so many functions are there, like making laws, maintaining law and order, providing public facilities, defending the nation from outside attacks and enemies, rescue and relief during the disaster, social and economic justice. So many works are there for the government to do. So it's not possible for the government to be located at one place and try to administer the country, things all over the world. So is it possible only one person can control all the country? Can one teacher control all the 12 classes? No. Even then, if she wants to go, she will be setting one monitor in each class. So in the same way, one person cannot control the whole or cannot take care of the whole country. And this is vast distance country, okay? So they have to have some elements spread out so that the functions could be carried out across the country. So different duties are assigned for each person that you have to do this. You have to see maybe the defense, you have to see the information and broadcasting, you have to see the railways, you have to see the water, you have to see human resource, so many responsibilities. You have to see particular state, you have to see UP, those different duties are assigned. Therefore, the government has divided its job and made different people responsible to carry out different duties. So, government has divided the duties and given different duties to different people so that we can do easily all. If all the work is given to one person, it's not going to be done soon, possibly peacefully. So duties are divided. Okay. So we have three levels of government. The first one is local level. Local level is at village level, which village, locality, district. This is local level government. जो आपके गांव में जो होता है ना, ग्राम पंचायत, ग्राम प्रधान. That is at local level, at small level. Okay. So in the book also you have the government at village, community, locality and district levels are known as your local government. They have to ensure that everything in the particular village, particular locality, particular district goes on well. They have to see that particular village, district responsibility, that everything goes on well there properly. Okay. Then you have state level government. In state level, government is little slightly higher than the local. Their state is given. Okay, now village, blocks, localities, districts, so many districts make a state. So this is slightly higher than the local government. They took affairs of the state and they pass order to the local government and see that the local government does it. So they look after the whole state, like UP is there. So UP state government will see the state, full UP, and in UP state, how many villages are coming, blocks are coming, districts are coming, they also have to look after that and give the different duties. Understood? So local government comes under the state government and state government comes under the national level, okay, the central government. So this is the next. You have the national level, like you also have here heard when I talk about state level, you say UP government or Rajasthan government or Punjab government. That means that particular state government. is responsible for that particular state. And in that particular state, all villages, all localities, all colonies, all district, they are responsible for it. And those state people divide duties to different district, villages and all. Understood local and the state? Then you have got national level. And this is the highest level of the government, in under which you will know that the whole country's responsibility comes under. The pass order to the all states, like the states pass order and rules to the different districts, the country, or we can say the central government or the national level government, is responsible for the whole country. Understood? Okay. So these are the three things you have. Levels of government, we have three: local, state, national. Local level is the lowest one, like you have to see the small units of the village, block, locality, colonies or the district. Okay, all the work into particular village, locality, district, they have to see, local government has to see. Then you have state level, where a particular state comes in. They have to see the particular state, like UP state will have their government, Bihar, Punjab, whatever you take. And state government is responsible for local government also. Then you have national level government, which is the highest level of government, that is looking after the whole country. Under the national level government only comes the state level government. Clear? Next we have here types of government. You must have heard there are different types of government. You have dictatorship, hereditary, which is called as monarchical, which when I was teaching you history, I told you monarchical, what is monarchical, or which is also hereditary, or dictatorship, or democratic. Which type of do we have in our country? We have democratic. Okay, so types of government. Next we have types of government. Okay, the first one we can take is monarchy. Monarchy. Now before that, thousands of years back, people lived in small groups. When you will read history, when you were learning also, पुराने सालों में लोग छोटे-छोटे groups में रहते थे ना. First man lived alone. Then he learned art of cultivation. He started living in small group. And that small group of people used to have an elder person who was like a guide for them. Okay? So जब सबसे aged man होता था, they used to take his advice. उसकी सलाह लेते थे, because he is most experienced one. And if any problem is there, they used to seek his advice. As he was old, they used to give him gift also to show the respect. Na, like we give the kings and all gift. So in the olden days, people were in small group. And in among the small group only, from that they used to choose the oldest member, sabse jo aged hai. And they used to take his advice and his opinion. And everything used to go well and very nicely. Then used to give him some gift and all to show their respect. As the group increased, jaise jaise group bade hote gaye, the tribal, the small group started turning into towns and villages. They started choosing headmen, pradhan choose shuru karna kar diya, okay? And he will be telling them what to do, what not to do, okay? Okay, now the small group too, they have become a big, maybe village or town. So they will have a headman. He is also an aged man, but headman. They will follow whatever his instructions were. He will give them judgment as per his likes and dislikes and the level of understanding. But once the groups of people living together became larger, it was not possible for man to control all. Now, as the group was increasing and increasing, छोटे से बड़ा ग्रुप हो गया और उससे भी बड़े ग्रुप होने लगे. सो इट वॉज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर वन मैन टू कंट्रोल अलोन सच अ बिग ग्रुप. देयरफॉर सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट केम. स्लोली स्लोली गवर्नमेंट केम. सो वी हैव व्हाई गवर्नमेंट केम. आई गेव यू एन आइडिया. पहले स्मॉल ग्रुप था. पीपल यूज टू टुक द एडवाइस ऑफ द ओल्ड पीपल. एज द ग्रुप बिगेम बिग, like a town or village. They used to have headmen. As it became more bigger, it was not able for a person to control all the people because of the large population. So the government started. So the first type of government is your monarchy, or which we say as hereditary also. Okay, where a king is there, a queen is there, they rule, all their rules and regulations are followed, and when they die, their son and daughter, probably the eldest son, becomes the next king or ruler. Understood? So the first system of government was the monarchy. In this form, the government, there is a king or a queen who is the head of the government, and they take all decisions with the help of few ministers. So in this type of government, ek raja hai ya fir rani hoti hai, and they take all decisions. They take help of some ministers also, and they decide whatever they like and they does not like, and people have to follow. Once they die or pass away, their children, the eldest son, will become the next ruler to rule that particular country. This system is also known as hereditary, as I told you. Those who have huge kingdoms usually place their selected people to control smaller parts, but such people have to obey all orders of the king. So all people have to obey the orders of the king. The monarchy is not answerable to the public. In this type of government, whoever is the king or queen, they are not responsible to answer ki aapne aisa kyun kiya. Raja se koi question nahi kar sakta hai. Like in democracy, we can question the government why this bill is passed. We can protest. We have right to opinion. But in monarchical government, people cannot ask the question to king and queen. Whatever they decide, the people had to follow. Okay? That is your monarchical or hereditary. Next we have dictatorship. Dictator. Okay. In this, in dictatorship, what happens? In dictatorship also, the power is only in one hand. Usually one hand or a group of people. And they manipulate people as they want, and nobody can go against them. You must have heard the name of Hitler. Usually this dictator person is from the army. Okay, so this is system of government where a man who is military, from the military, takes over the government by use of force. So he is not getting it by rule. Jaan pooch ke zabardasti किसी कंट्री को और सत्ता को अपने हाथों में लेना होता है. He then with his friends and supporters starts to govern the region. So first is he is taking forcefully that region, and with the help of his friends or some well-wishers and supporters, he takes control of that particular country and governs there. Normally such governments use force on people. They persecute people a lot, harm the people whom they want. They do whatever they want. They are also generally very harsh, and they do not like other person snatching the power. They want to rule as they want. They don't want to listen to anyone. No other political party, like we have so many political parties here na to contest, and you have BJP, Congress, BSP, SP, so many. But in dictatorship, only one government is there of a person or a group of people. No other party is there to contest with them, or also there is no media allowed to put forth whatever they are doing on. If anybody goes against the dictatorship government, they are persecuted and also not allowed at all. The people living under both monarchical and dictatorship government are controlled by one person. So both these type of government, in monarchical and dictatorship government, people are controlled by one person or a group of person. Okay, so for example, here it is given, it's toughest and strongest child. Nobody will like that government. Imagine you get a child in your class monitor, okay, who is very healthy but very naughty. Okay, here it is given, child in class one who has who would start things like he wants. He is beating you all, writing your name uselessly, and showing his power all the time, eating up your tiffin and bullying you all, and if you inform the teacher, I will beat you and all that. Would you like to have that principal? We don't choose such type of, sorry, monitors. We don't choose such type of monitors. We want a monitor who is cool, calm, good in studies, and also is sensible. He knows the needs of the class. What is sensitive to the needs of the class? Like that children, we choose the monitor. Same is with the government. Okay, the last type of government that we have and which we follow in our country is your democracy. Now in democracy, where the people are choosing the representative, is the best form of government. Here is the leaders and representative of the government are chosen by the people here. Okay, and they discuss and decide what is good and bad for the people, and people also have the right to ask the government why these things are done, why these things should not be done, and they have a choice. Next time they may not choose that representative. Okay, so democracy is form of government where the people select their leaders. We choose by voting, we choose our representative. In large countries with huge population, it's not possible to have only one leader. Is it possible to have one leader only in such a big country who can rule the whole country? It's not possible. So people of different regions select the leader. So like in India, we have from different region, we choose our representatives. है ना, इलेक्शंस होते हैं तो हर एक स्टेट से डिस्ट्रिक्ट से डिफरेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स खड़े होते हैं, कंटेस्ट करते हैं, एंड वी चूज आवर एंड वी वोट फॉर दैट. सच सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव डेमोक्रेसी, एज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द पीपल फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट आर चूजन. वी आवर रिप्रेजेंट, हमारे लिए आई कैन नॉट स्टैंड, सो माई रिप्रेजेंटेटिव समबडी फ्रॉम माई एरिया हुम आई सपोर्ट इज रिप्रेजेंटेटिंग अस, सो आई वोट फॉर दैट पर्सन. ओके, and they have a fixed time, 5 years, 3 years, until then they rule, and if I am happy with them, then next time I can choose them again or I will not choose them. This is what about is your democracy. Okay, so you know, name three levels of government. Which are the three levels of government? Local government, state and the national. Who takes decisions in monarchical government? Who is taking all the decisions in monarchical government is the king or the queen. Which form of government is hereditary? I told you, hereditary and monarchy, same type of government. Why does dictatorship does not like? Dictatorship government will not last long. Why? Because people are not happy in that type of government. People are not happy, people are not given right, and they are persecuted much. Then why is democracy called representative democracy? Because representatives of people form the government. Log jo unko representative choose karte, they make the government. This is for today. We have learnt about types of government: monarchical, dictatorship and democracy. And we also have learnt about levels of government. You read the chapter. If any problem, you can ask me before that once you read. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye, children.